Yvonne, we are going to talk about the asymptotes to a function, and it is very, very good, useful to find identity of a function. And the asymptotes mostly is appear by functions which have division or squared function, mostly oddly squared function. And we are going to find the asymptotes if f of x is equal to u of x divided by v of x, then v of x equals to 0 is asymptote. Is asymptote. And you have a rule. Is mean a divided by x power by 2k minus 1. Then k is a natural number and it is and if goes to 0, then this expression goes to plus minus 8 and a is not 0. But this one fish by a sign multiplied by infinite. Another case is lim a 2k plus minus, because the denominator is off potent, and that sign and that sign is the same. Okay, now we are going to y equals to 2x minus 1 divided by 62 minus 4. Then 62 minus 4 equals 0. Then x is plus minus 2 squared, square 2. The function it is 2 and it is minus 2, and we have 2 asymptotes, and the function is inside this asymptote. And we are going to have a function y equals to first of the 62 minus 4 is plus 3 divided by x minus 2, and the definition of this would be squared by x minus 1, x minus 3 divided by x minus 2, and this one must be positive. Then x greater than 3, less than 1, and for a symptom, if it is true, which is not belong to this interval, then this function hasn't any asymptote. Then this is 2 plus 82 divided by 4 is 0 of x is 2. Then it is 4 plus 2a. from A from here, minus 4 plus here, 16, minus 15, then A, A is minus 4. And B, A is minus 4, which is 16 divided by 4 is 4. And B is 4. Okay. B, we have that condition, then it is Y is goes to plus infinity if this one is 0. And it gives us that expression, and that expression exists. Then, because it is true, this one must be 0. It is it, solve B, put it in that expression, solve A, and put back in that expression, find C. We are going to have another function. Divided by 4 minus u plus 3 divided by 2 plus u must be 0. 2 divided by 4 is this one, q plus 3 divided by 16 u minus u plus g divided by 2 plus u equals to 0. When we expand it, we find the solution. When we expand it, we put u equals to 1 divided by 4 is equal. The another question is interesting too. That and it is not true. So this one must be 0, then minus a half plus minus a half divided by 2 power by 3 plus 8. This cannot be 0. This is always positive. It's always positive. Then it's always positive. Then to get only one asymptote, this one must have a coefficient on the part of this denominator. So x2 minus plus ax minus a divided by x minus 2 is x, x2 minus 2 is x, 2 plus 8, x minus 8 plus 2 plus 8, 2 plus 8, 8 minus 2, 2 plus 8, zero, then 8 plus 2 multiplied by 2 plus 8 must be 0. So this is 16, it is 2 plus 8 is minus 4, and 8 is minus 6. Y become x minus 2, x minus 2 multiplied by, this is protect each other, and it runs 6 minus 4, and the board 6 plus 2, 4, 1 plus 2, 20, and it is the ascension, the only ascension left. Okay. It was the vertical ascension. What about the horizontal ascension? What about horizontal ascension? We are going to find line F, then it goes to plus minus infinity. Always this equals to 2x2 minus 3 divided by x2 minus 2. So we are going to x equals to plus minus infinity, and it is horizontal ascension. If y is equal to x2 minus, no, y is plus 7 divided by2x minus 4. Then we are going to move x to plus minus this one, and to the square, which is this one, and x plus this one minus b divided by 2, and this one goes to 2x. Then x goes to b equals to 1 divided by 2, because this one is going to be as x corresponding, and 1, 2, this is 1 divided by 2. Another example is x minus 2 plus x2 minus 2x minus 1 equals to approximately minus infinite plus infinite equals to infinite. So we are going to use the we are going to use the corresponding of each. Then it's minus 2 plus divided by 2 equals to 2e minus 3 then it goes to the last then goes to plus infinite, and then it goes to minus infinite. Then it is minus 2 minus is minus 1, which is 1. Then we have only one horizontal asymptote. And another one is square 4 is covered by 2 plus 2 plus 6 divided by 2 minus 2e minus 3e. Then y equals to plus minus plus minus e. This is infinite minus infinite and infinite minus infinite minus or plus infinite. Then use the corresponding. Then it is the square 4 multiplied by x minus or plus 0 divided by 8 plus x minus 2 divided by 2 minus 3x. This one is x multiplied by 4, which is 2, plus 1 minus 3, which is 0. Then divide the x axis is the horizontal asymptote. And equals to AX plus B plus X2 minus X plus 1. Find A and B so that line Y is 2 when X goes to minus infinity. It is minus infinity plus infinity then it is unclear. Then we use the correspondence then it is AX plus B plus X minus 6 divided by 2 which is X 1 plus A plus B minus 3. But this also this one is 1 plus A when x goes to minus it is 1 plus a equals to minus 2 then a is minus 3 but this one right side missing x, then 1 plus a is 0 and b minus 3 is 2, then a is minus 1 and b is 1. Y equals to minus 2x plus 3 plus where ax2 minus 4x plus 1 a and b so that line y is 1 x equals to plus then we are going to use equivalent method minus 2x plus b plus square a multiplied by x minus 4 divided by 2a and equals to and then plus by missing x, then this is 0 x squared minus 2 is 0, then a is 2, and this expression b minus 2 divided by a squared is 1, then b is 1 plus 2, a squared is the squared 4, is 2, which is 2. Because we are going to talk about the Lind asymptote, and it's it takes more time to talk. Okay, see you in next tutorial or video.